doing.
Almost dead, guys. Oh my god. We all leveled up. Except for Devil of Carrick. Holy crap.
Light, flame, and sound. We'll keep to ourselves.
Oh my god. Can we immediately rest? I really... yeah. Normal stuff we find on these guys. All still alive, I'm very happy about that. Okay, shall we level our people up? Actually, before anything happens. That's not gonna be easy to repeat. So yeah, going on part three here. Seven. All right, give her athletics. Get another, we're gonna get stasis shell. Not sure when I'll get to use that. I mean, other, I can use one of these. Tactical meld. An attack bonus against I kinda like that. Plus 20 accuracy when attacking the same enemy as the target. I like that. I'm gonna take that. So, yeah, that. Ooh, Acolyte's Radiance. I don't remember all this stuff. Apprentice's sneak attack. Not gonna read all this, guys. You guys can see. What's a debuff? Gallant forces. Gallant focus, actually, sorry. Oh, unarmed? Yeah. Outlander's Frenzy. So these are, they're just getting talents that they, you know, normally other classes would use. As a hedge wizard. Duplicate the effects of the most popular spells. That is powerful. Huh, summon skeletons, but it requires at least 15 seconds in combat. Summons two human skeletons. I like that. Leaning towards that. Rumors wounding shot. Runner's wounding shot. Hobbled. Veteran's recovery. Let me get the skeletons. It's a good, you know, because Kanna's not in the group anymore, so we don't have summons. So we'll take that. I wonder if we can take on that dragon now. Down in that cave underneath, what do you call it, falls? I forget. six? Is points left six? I'm not gonna take any this time. I'm gonna carry it on to the next level. Okay, we've got some more warding staff. Substantial phantom. Cool. It can cast spells. Wall of draining. I'm gonna take substantial phantom. Hardened veil. That's pretty cool. I'm not gonna bother with the bonus spells. Acolyte's Radiance. Well, this is all the same stuff. Okay. Outlander's Frenzy. I guess this is just talents that's for anybody. I'm gonna take this, Veteran's Recovery, for him. That's a good amount of points for him. His percentage will go up quicker. Adair. He looks different to me now. It's been so long since I leveled him up, I guess? Let's take Survival. What does that mean? Concealed. I guess it means it's not gone, it's just temporarily suspended. Novice is suffering. Yeah, I'm not gonna do unarmed. That's pretty good, plus 4 accuracy. Aspirant Mark. Wounding shot. Okay. I'm gonna take that for him. Durance. I'm gonna take another in mechanics, and that's done with that. The priest's condemnations of an enemy become more apt, increasing the accuracy of his or her interdiction ability. Inspired Flame. Aggrandizing Radiance. I'm gonna take Empowered Interdiction. Even though I don't use it very often, I should be using it. I think. And finally, Palagina. Gonna give her... nothing. Critical focus. A it's not very much, is it? That's why I haven't taken that before. Maybe the sneak attack type thing? Don't know. Let me take running shot for her too. Seems pretty useful. For encounter, I think it is. What now? So she just did all this, and we save. I mean, is that it? Was there something else going on here?
Sure.
I mean, we've activated it. Hold up. We need to figure out how to use it. My quest log hasn't been updated. I don't know, let's go back to that cart. Before I start hopping out somewhere else where I can't go. Maybe there's something else I need to do here, I don't know. Battle was so difficult. Oh, two here. Maybe there's something else we need to find with this mining cart. This empty mine cart sits upon the tracks leading down a dark mining tunnel. There was a lever beside it. Look inside the cart. The cart is empty, if dusty and patchy with the rust, and large enough that a group of kith might fit inside uncomfortably. Let's go climb in uncomfortably. You and your allies clamber into the minecart in a graceless jumble of jabbing elbows and weapons. That's funny. Pull the lever. With a shriek of grinding metal, the lever slides into place. The cart gives a mighty shudder, then starts rolling slowly along the track. The mine cart moves downhill and quickly gathers speed. On the next rise, it becomes clear that there is some form of enchantment upon the tracks. The cart loses none of its momentum. After a sharp turn, you find yourself rapidly approaching a fork in the tracks. One track leads left, and another upward and to the right. Look around quickly. You notice another lever set alongside the tracks. The minecart hurtles toward it. Grab the lever as you pass. Who will grab for the lever? Who's quickest? Do we need, like dexterity or strength here? Have, I don't know, have a dare do it. In a show of agility, Adair manages to hang over the side of the cart and grab the lever as it comes along. The lever slams into place, and the impact nearly knocks Adair out of the cart. Let's go see your athletic score. Which there are certainly people better at that than him. There was a grinding noise, and then the track shift ahead of you just in time. The cart rattles onto the right track. After a dizzying series of turns and twists, the minecart slows, then stops at the entrance to a new cavern. Oh. What's here?
Quickly and quietly.
Dented minecarts and heaps of rubble block this tunnel. Fifty more Durgan cogwheels. I figure we need the ingot and the cogwheels for something. Two sapphires, more ingot, sigil of the shield. Carvings on one side of the stone disc depict a shield. On its back, two protrusions poke out from its expertly polished surface. So what do we do with this? That's it. Another minecart sits at the mouth of an ascending tunnel. You cannot be sure where it leads apart from out of this room. I make a new file. Oh no. 48. These are just numbers right now, guys. I don't know what episode we're up to. Hop in. You and your companions clamber into the minecart. You pull the lever and hear the now familiar whine of rusty wheels as the minecart starts rolling along the track. After a series of gentle twists and turns, the cart approaches a familiar cavern. Back to here. We just automatically come here, okay. What if we hadn't turned the thing? Huh. I don't know, let's look downstairs again, then. I don't know. Nothing to do here? Okay. Well, we saved. I guess let's take that jump and see what happens then. I don't know what else to do here. Still says I need to figure out how to use it, and it's active. I don't know.
First, your neighbors hound you because you say the wrong prayers at supper time.
If it wasn't that, it'd be something else. Just their way of letting you know they care.
Then some cross-eyed lord gets to stringing up your neighbors.
A couple of them were ones that had been hounding me, so that worked out at least.
Quickly and quietly.
Alright, let's take this and see what happens, I guess. Jump across. Read this before. Doubt you'll be able to return the same way. You leap, and for a dizzying moment, the ground below flashes past, and then you are across the gap and upon the second tower. Have I been up here?
I'll keep an eye out.
I think I've been up here. I think this goes back down to where we were. Oh, it goes all the way down there. Okay. Well, I'm going to have to think on this, on what to do next. Because... apparently we still need to know how to figure out how to use it. So, I don't know, maybe we need to talk to some more people? I don't know. I don't even see an option to do anything else with it. So, yeah. Thanks for watching, everyone. See you next time. And endure. And enduring, grow strong.